हे, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। आज इंजीनियर्स नहीं है, वो पीछे के बेंच खाली दिख रहे हैं। सो आई एम जितेश, आई एम एन इंजीनियर टर्न मार्केटर एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट वर्डप्रेस कॉर्नरस्टोन कंटेंट द राइट वे। सो आई वर्क एज अ मार्केटिंग मैनेजर एट हमिंगबर्ड वेब सॉल्यूशंस प्राइवेट लिमिटेड। यू सॉ आर सीईओ एंकरिंग द मॉडरेटिंग द डिस्कशन पैनल येस्टरडे। इट वॉज फन, राइट? सो वी हैड अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग सेशन फ्रॉम गौरव राइट नाउ, राइट? देर वॉज अ क्वेश्चन अबाउट वॉइस सर्च, राइट? आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सपांड अ लिटिल बिट अपॉन दैट आस्पेक्ट इन दिस सेशन एंड टेक इट अ लिटिल बिट फर्दर। Before I begin my session, I would quickly like to know how many of you deal in SEO over here? Touch SEO, थोड़ा बहुत SEO देखते हो, Yoast यूज करते हो, टाइटल चेंज करते हो, मेटा डिस्क्रिप्शन डालते हो, एनीथिंग, लिंक बिल्ड करते हो? ऑलमोस्ट एवरी वन, राइट? दैट्स ऑलमोस्ट एवरी वन। एंड वी हैव बीन हियरिंग दिस फ्रॉम अ लॉन्ग 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 टाइम। That, एक बार अपने आजू बाजू देखो, क्विकली लुक एट योर लेफ्ट फर्स्ट, एवरीबडी लुक एट योर लेफ्ट, लुक एट योर राइट, राइट राइट, एकदम राइट मुंडी हिला दो। द पीपल दैट यू सी आर मोर इंपॉर्टेंट देन द गूगल बॉट, राइट? वी बीन हियरिंग दिस फॉर अ लॉन्ग 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 टाइम, बट लाइक इंजीनियर्स वी आर गीक्स, right? All SEO experts are geeks. So what do? We try to find out ways where we can cater to this bot and forget about the users. Things have been changing rapidly since the last 1.5-2 years, right? And we saw probably a culmination of that in the last week of October when Google introduced what? Anybody? BERT. Yeah, Google introduced their BERT algorithm. So what does this BERT algorithm do? Anyone? So far, our keywords kaise hote the? WordCamp Mumbai. Abhi prepositions bhi honge. WordCamp in Mumbai. Right? So, or it could be WordCamp for marketers. वर्ड कैम मार्केटर्स नहीं होगा। सो इन फॉर, ये जो प्रेपोजिशंस है, दीज विल बिकम एक्सट्रीमली इंपॉर्टेंट इन योर सर्च क्वेरीज नाउ। दैट इज वाई द फर्स्ट कंसेप्ट दैट वी नीड टू लर्न इज दैट पीपल आर मोर इंपॉर्टेंट दैन सर्च बॉट्स। ओके, दैट्स वॉट आई एम गोइंग टू कवर टूडे यूजिंग कॉर्नरस्टोन कंटेंट। यू आर गोइंग टू कवर 3 questions. Why cornerstone content? What is cornerstone content? And how do you implement it in WordPress? And hopefully, by the end of my session, you'll be able to take home 3 lessons, which you'll be able to implement on your own website, blog, or business. Okay, let's get started. So it's nice to say that people are important than bots. But what's the hard evidence that tells us this? Okay, so like I said, we saw the evidence of this from the last 1.5-2 years. Okay, I'm going to go first to Buffer. Buffer did this study on 1 million+ shared pieces of content. We all know that longer pieces of content get shared more, appear more frequently in the top 3 positions on your Google SERPs, right? So this was the first study which told us ki longer content matter karta hai. But we saw some contrary information in Ahrefs. Ahrefs is a tool that you use for doing your SEO. What is that contrary information? Almost 2 out of every 3 searches on Google are either 4 words or more. right? And typically these four words or more, what are these? Typically, these are long tail keywords, right? We all know that. Or long tail keyword ke upar, how can you write 3,000 words, 4,000 words, 10,000 word articles? That's difficult. There was more evidence to this study. This is a distribution of keywords versus their search volume. 92% of keywords get 10 or less searches per month. 92% of Google keyword searches get 10 or less searches per month. What does this tell you? That's 1.9 billion keywords analyzed. And 92% get less than 10 searches per month. What does that tell you? That tells us, number one, that keywords are extremely varied. Long before BERT, Google was looking at prepositions. Google was looking at search intent. Google was looking at the geography where the user was searching these keywords for. And everyone types in their keywords differently, right? That's why majority of the keywords that you see get less than 10 searches. Agar hum log sab log milke yahan pe ek ek keyword search karenge to alag alag tarike se karenge, not the same way. That is why they get less than 10 searches per month, right? So what's the solution to all of this? The solution is cornerstone content, right? And in order to create cornerstone content, I want you to take this one thing away with you. The way we have been thinking about our content strategy, the structure of our content, website, blog, whatever, and the way we create our content needs to change immediately if you've not done it already. Right? What do I mean by that? So far, what we have been doing, keyword search kiya. Depending on how good you are at keyword search, you found some keywords and then you took that keyword, wrote an article. If you are a true content marketer, you distributed it well, got traffic from social media, paisa hai to Facebook ad bhi kiya, right? And if your content piece was really good, maybe it went viral, maybe you became famous, right? This is how we used to do our content marketing so far. Unfortunately, writing keyword-based content is going to change now. This is no longer going to help you get into the top 10 places of Google. Okay? So, cornerstone content will help you overcome this challenge. Right? What is cornerstone content? Let's go back 30 years, 40 years. Let's say you are a business then. And let's say someone wants to buy from you. What would that person would have to do? Let's say someone wanted a swimming pool installed in their backyard and you were a swimming pool company. What would that person have to do? They had to visit your store or factory. First, they will have to call you. They'll have thousands of questions about swimming pools. Kya type ke hote hai? क्या कॉस्ट होता है, कितना ड्यूरेबिलिटी होता है, मेंटेनेंस क्या होता है, दे विल हैव थाउजेंड्स ऑफ क्वेश्चंस, राइट? सम यू माइट नॉट हैव थॉट ऑफ, चिल्ड्रन के लिए सेफ होता है क्या, बच्चों के लिए सेफ होता है क्या, मेनी क्वेश्चंस, विल आई, व्हाट म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन परमिशंस विल आई हैव टू टेक, सो मेनी क्वेश्चंस वुड क्रॉप अप इन देयर माइंड, राइट? एंड यू वुड सिट देयर एंड पेशेंटली एक्सप्लेन दैट टू देम. दैट्स व्हाट कॉर्नरस्टोन कंटेंट इज. Right now, the way we create our content is infinite. Agar kisi website ke liye mere ko content banana hai, is there an end to where I stop creating content? Till I keep finding new keywords, I'll keep creating content. Simple, right? But with cornerstone content, it's not like that. You only need to answer the questions that people have. Right? That's what cornerstone content is. It is no longer about keyword, it is about the topic, swimming pool ke baare mein. Swimming pool kaise banana hai uske baare mein. You understand? It is no longer about swimming pools in Mumbai. या स्विमिंग पूल कंस्ट्रक्टर्स इन मुंबई. इट इज़ अबाउट वॉइस सर्च. हाउ डू आई गेट अ स्विमिंग पूल इंस्टॉल्ड इन माई बैकयार्ड? हाउ मच डज अ स्विमिंग पूल कॉस्ट? इट्स ऑल अबाउट क्वेश्चंस. डू यू अंडरस्टैंड द डिफरेंस? इट्स ऑल अबाउट द टॉपिक. सो दैट्स वॉट कॉर्नरस्टोन कंटेंट इज. कॉर्नरस्टोन कंटेंट इज द मोस्ट बेसिक इंडिस्पेंसिबल एसेंशियल पीस ऑफ कंटेंट ऑन योर वेबसाइट विच आंसर्स ऑल द क्वेश्चंस योर कस्टमर्स विल हैव अबाउट योर प्रोडक्ट, राइट? एंड इट इज ऑल अबाउट द टॉपिक दैट योर प्रोडक्ट आंसर्स फॉर, द प्रॉब्लम्स दैट योर प्रोडक्ट सॉल्व्स. ओके, सो कॉर्नरस्टोन कंटेंट हैज अ लॉट ऑफ डिफरेंट नेम्स. The first I heard about cornerstone content was from Brian Clark of Copy Blogger. This was way back in 2007. But it gained true significance when HubSpot, one of our sponsors, they called it pillar and cluster content or topic cluster content. Then I don't remember the name of the person. Someone gave it a name. It's called hub and spoke content model. Okay, so let's look at what this model looks like. So this is what HubSpot defines it. The central topic, the blue pillar that you see, the dark blue pillar, that's your cornerstone content, the pillar content of your website, right? Which is the basic, essential, indispensable content that answers all the questions that your customers have about your product or solution. It's an overview of everything, let's say, about swimming pools. Right? And then there is a cluster of content around it. What permissions do I need to take? What materials will be used? Are those materials harmful to children? Are they organic? How much water will it waste? Right? All of those questions need to be answered in different pieces of content which can be shorter in length. And then all of these pieces of content together create a topic cluster. The structure of your website is no longer a blog, one post after another. It's a well-structured piece of content which answers questions about your product or service. Got that? Right? So let's take a few examples. If you have been in SEO for any length of time, everyone knows this, the beginner's guide to SEO by Moz. Right, where the pillar content is organized into different chapters. The chapters form the clusters, and the pillar content is your beginner's guide to SEO. Brand Dean, everyone knows Brand Dean, Backlinko, right? Link building guide for SEO. Again, you will see this is one big piece of pillar content, right? And links to other blog topics of his, like SEO ranking factors or outreach methods for link building. This one is very interesting, Typeform. Does anyone here know Typeform? Heard about Typeform? Yeah. So Typeform is like VForms, VDevs apne jo ye hai, ya Gravity Forms, ya Contact Form 7, whatever you are using, right? But it's a hosted solution. They have created this topic cluster called brand awareness. On the right hand side, you will see the clusters which link to the various cluster articles for this particular pillar content. Right? So you can go there and you can try and understand why did Typeform, a form, create content about brand awareness? That's interesting, right? Why does a form tool need to create a content about brand awareness? Find out. It's a really interesting reason. So what's pillar content? It's an overview of a specific topic, right, which relates to your product or solution. Moz ka SEO, Typeform ka brand awareness, right, branding ka link building. It is long form, typically 3,000 to 10,000 words long. Sometimes some people have even created 20,000 words long content. It could become a small book. And it has an optional opt-in where you can either give your email address to download the PDF version of this long form content, or you could download a content upgrade like a checklist that goes along with this piece of content. What is cluster content? It's a subtopic, not your main topic, right? It is keyword focused. यहाँ पे keyword आ जाता है. This is keyword focused. You are catering to the search engine over here. With the pillar content, you are catering to the people, not the search engine, right? And it links to the pillar, right? So this is your takeaway two. You create a pillar content, you optimize it for conversions. Get email addresses from people, get them to download your pillar content, and use that pillar content as a lead generation page. But your cluster content, you build it for search engines, optimize it for keywords. So how do you implement this in WordPress? Okay, look straightforward, but there are a few tricks you need to do to get this implemented in WordPress. So what will you use for pillar content? Page, post, category? Anyone? Page. Someone said page. Yeah. So why page? Why not a category? Okay. Yes, agreed. So there are a couple of reasons why we use a page instead of a category. First of all, category is an archive page, right, where you have a list of blog posts. It's not sequential, right? The way you want people to learn about your topic, it's not in that sequence. It's in the sequence in which you have written your blog posts, right? That's one problem with category pages. The second problem with category pages is the editing experience is extremely limited. And if you look at the examples of pillar pages that I showed you, they are richly edited pieces of content. You'll find a lot of infographics, you'll find a lot of videos, you'll find a lot of formatting, right? Which is not possible if you want to edit a category description right now in your default WordPress system, right? And the third thing is pages are kind of, have a kind of permanence to them. They are not like blog posts, chronological, or they can't get hidden on page two of your main blog page, right? They will be there always, your pages. That's why you use pages for your pillar content. Let's look at an example of how we do this. So let's say you're building a fitness website where your main topic is workout routines, and then you have various other cluster topics like how do you work out without weights, how do you work out at home, how do you get abs, right? Obviously, I am not the person who is building this kind of a website. So for pillar content, you will use a WordPress page. Your URL would look something like this, myfitsite.com/workoutroutines. You will link it from your site navigation menu so that Google finds it easily. This is extremely important. And you link to the other cluster content about workout routines from your pillar page. Next, your cluster content. These will be WordPress posts, right? Now, ideally, you want your URL to be myfitsite.com/workoutroutines/4abs or /fatloss or /athome, right? And it links back to pillar content. But there's a problem here. Can anybody tell me what the problem is? Posts cannot be children of your pages. So if you're using the URL workout routines for your pillar page, how can you get a /4abs or a /fatloss or a /athome in WordPress? That's the slight problem that we have in WordPress, right? Google expects you to have your pillar and cluster content organized this way. But we can't do that right now in WordPress as it is. So we have to do a little bit of jugaad. And that jugaad is step number one. Your blog posts need to have a custom structure permalinks /category/post name. Right? So I'll tell you why. Just need to know this for now. In the next slide, I'll explain why do you need that category in your permalink. then that's your category which you create workout routines. Slash category slash workout routines will be the permalink of your category. Right? But we also have a pillar page which is slash workout routines. Your cluster posts are a part of that category. So there, and because you've set your permalink to slash category slash post name, they'll appear as slash workout routines slash for apps, or slash workout routines slash fat loss, or slash workout routines slash home. Right? But you don't want people to go to the category page. We want them to come to our pillar page. So you do a 301 redirect to your pillar page. That's a small jugaad that you need to do to get your cornerstone content to work properly. All right? So takeaway number three, you have to create the right content structure with the right permalinks and the right internal links. All right? So that's my presentation. If you have any questions, I'll be happy to take them. Once again, I'm Jitesh. I work at Hummingbird Web Solutions. I look after CyberChimps and WPAK, where we create beautiful WordPress themes and very useful WordPress plugins. Do check out both the websites.